In July 2021, security agencies launched an operation codenamed Usalama kwa Wowote to restore stability in the volatile Karamoja sub-region by dealing with cattle rustlers. But MPs from Karamoja have had reservations on these operations until today. While addressing the press conference at Parliament today, members of the Karamoja Parliamentary Caucus have announced their full support for the ongoing disarmament operations in Karamoja, saying the region is seeing restoration of peace, which has been absent for a while.
We are now seeing there is peace coming back to Karamoja. And we know after the gun is removed, we shall come back to Karamoja in the other 10 years where we used to move from south up to the north peacefully.
We strongly believe that this is what is going to bring peace and sanity in that region. Moreover, it is in line with our recommendations and prayers by the people of Karamoja during our caravan that this be done.
Led by Karamoja Parliamentary Group Chairperson Remigio Achia, legislators have applauded President Museveni and UPDF 3rd Division for reigning over the insecurity that has claimed a lot of lives.
I want to thank His Excellency President Museveni for the recent deployment of more troops, both in the neighboring districts, neighboring Karamoja, Chorilango, Teso, and Bugisho and Sebei, and also within the 9 districts of Karamoja, with the purpose to stem insecurity, to remove illegal guns in the hands of civilians, and secure the lives and property of the people of Uganda. This is what we have been yearning and requesting for government for a long time.
While they support the disarmament operations, Karamoja legislators have appealed to UPDF and police to avoid elements of torture and prolonged detention of suspects in their operations.
We want detention centers to be human friendly, so that when their boys and girls are arrested, they are living in an environment that is conducive for human beings. We also want the operations to be intelligent led in the way we were promised.
We want Karamoja to be like any other part of this region in terms of peace. But this exercise should not really bring much suffering to the people of Karamoja, because the Karamojong are also Ugandans.
They have called upon security agencies to quickly sit with MPs, RDCs and DSOs to agree on operational guidelines in order to minimize atrocities and human rights violations.
In order to avoid the mistakes of previous disarmaments, such as human rights violations, victimization, mistaken identity, and the problem of same names. In Karamoja, you find that over 20, 30 boys can be named after one elder, and they carry the same name, but it's possible that one or two of them may have a gun, and the problem of victimization emerges from the same names. We want to avoid elements of torture which were prevalent in the previous disarmament, and also we want to avoid long detention.
We would encourage the security team that is carrying out this exercise to move with the local leadership so that they witness this to avoid any cases of thefts.
They have also called for intelligence-led operations to avoid arrest of innocent people and immediate screening of the arrested suspects.
The moment is okay, it's welcome, but they act, especially when they are talking about detention. It should not be something that is for the two things. We can use it, no, locally like that, that you are supposed to pay in order to be released. That is depopulating the pockets or the monies that is supposed to develop Karamoja.
Sometimes subjecting innocent people like relatives into punishments because they want to press them to, in order to get probably the gun of one of their relatives. For example, parents subjected into punishments because their sons are criminals, they have the guns.
On May 19th, Parliament approved a supplementary budget of 87.3 billion shillings to facilitate UPDF operations in Karamoja. This report was compiled by Fred Kajubi for the news.